Yo, what's up guys, it's Steve from Lucas and Steve with another small tip for your productions. Of course you have a bass line and you have a kick and you don't want them to clash together. It's a really small tip and probably a lot of you guys know it already, but sidechaining your bass on your kick makes your track breathe more open, so your headroom will be a lot more. So when your kick comes in, you don't want your bass to clash. Normally we sidechain all the time and we use a lot of Nick Romero's Kickstarter, which is awesome. But for this track with W&W, we first bounced our bass line because we have a Moog sub Fetty. And if we want to use all the other external instruments that we have right here, then we have to bounce it because it's all analog. We got a Signal and that's an audio track over here. Then we made some fades to actually let the kick do the work. And when the kick gets down, the bass gets up. That's actually the basic part of sidechaining. We did that already in our audio file, but to be a little bit more safe, we used sidechaining. So if you wanna give your kick like that space that it needs to really pump, then use sidechain on your bass line or on which channel that you use. But for now, I wanna explain it to on the kick and on the sub. So it sounds like this. Thank you for watching. Next week we will be back with a brand new tip for you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you enjoyed it, go to our producer platform. It's on www.lucasandsteve.com. Subscribe and we'll see you later.